we transition to the Western Church with a simple Gregorian chant setting of the Magnificat. There are simple chant settings in each of the eight ancient church modes. We refer to music today as being in a major or minor tonality, but this did not exist before the Renaissance era. Gregorian chants were composed to either be sung for the celebration of the Mass or for the praying of the liturgy of the hours, where the Magnificat was sung during Vespers, known today as evening prayer. Unlike some Gregorian chants, which are quite complicated, this one is based on a psalm tone of which there is one specific to each mode. This particular psalm tone might sound familiar, as it is still used on occasion as the psalmist proclaims the verses of the psalm or the Alleluia at Mass.
Thank you.
the Turning is a contemporary adaptation of the Magnificat text by Rory Cooney and is set to the Irish traditional tune, Star of the County Down. Here's what he has to say about his setting. The Song of Mary celebrates the story of Mary's visitation in the even wider context of Jewish song, as the Magnificat itself parallels the Song of Hannah, the mother of Samuel, in the first book of Kings 2. God takes action in the world on behalf of the powerless, the song goes on, lifting up the lowly, filling the hungry, tearing the mighty from their thrones. I decided that I wanted to use music that suggested the revolutionary spirit of the Canticle, that cosmic tables are being turned over, as it were. And who has better songs of uprising than the Irish? Star of the County Down is not a revolutionary ballad, of course. It is a love song about a man who aspires to woo Rosie McCann, a brown-haired beauty from the banks of the Bain near Belfast. The tune dances a bit, and there's both joy and excitement in the melody that I think fits the spirit of Mary's song well. Like many folk songs, and in the spirit of Martin Luther, it is a self-teaching melody with a two-line refrain whose melody is expanded and paralleled in the verses, making the tune easy to learn and remember. The idea of Turning in the title was both a nod to the inner conceit of revolution, derived from the Latin volvere, which means to turn, and to the message of Jesus' preaching in all three of the Synoptic Gospels, the core message of which was, repent and believe the good news. Repent translates a Greek verb, the noun from which is metanoia, that is to say, complete change of the self, of mind and heart, which might also be rendered as turn around. The idea, of course, is that we are all walking a particular course dictated by the gods of this world. For Jesus and his countrymen, the God's name was Caesar. Jesus was saying, look, how is that working out for you? Happy? Well, I have good news. A God with another idea, and his name is Abba. Let's turn around and walk in another direction. So the revolution is both interior, a change of heart self, and corporate and visible, a new way of living together. It is, in fact, against the prevailing set of values in society, a revolution. But I want to emphasize that it is a peaceful revolution, a revolution of action, persuasion, and justice. In the spirit of Miriam of Egypt, Hannah and Miriam of Nazareth, Canticle of the Turning invites us to sing around the fire in darkness while we awake in new worlds dawn.
Thank you.
and an important part of the Anglican tradition of choral evensong, which is a combination of what evening prayer and compline are to Roman Catholics. Many of the great English composers have composed settings of the Magnificat for this purpose. This powerful setting for unison treble voices was composed by George Dyson as part of the evening service where the Song of Simeon was also sung. This piece continues to be a staple in the choral tradition of the Anglican Church.
Oh,
The text of the Song of Mary is punctuated by joyous refrains of Magnificat animal mea dominum. My soul rejoices in God my Savior. As we draw near to our sacred remembrance of the Incarnation, let us always remember Mary's yes. And may we always try to do the same as we strive to echo